Welcome to a special video edition of Pod Rides. Today we're webcasting from the Jacksonville International Car and Truck Show, and we've got a muscle car revival. As always, I'm Bill Bordsfield, along with Times Union auto writer Dan Scanlon, and we've got the new Shelby right behind us.
I know, the Shelby is here, and the new Ford GT is here. Then our surprise is that beautiful Ford Taurus in the background, which is actually the Ford 500, and it has been redesigned. It is elegant looking. A very nice lineup here for Ford. They've got a classic current model Mustang convertible here, and then you've got the long nose on the Shelby with the hood scoops. You've got the cool nose and the gold color on the GT. It's wonderful. But then I look out here and I see that cool Honda S2000, the last year that it's going to be made, and this is the track version with the big wing. You see the Honda Fit, which is roomy, compact, fun, 30 plus miles per gallon. I see hybrid trucks, hybrid cars. We got the new Camaro. It's amazing, just within spitting distance of where we're standing, the stuff that's here. Admittedly, a tough time for the auto industry. We have a few less car companies that are showing here, but what they're showing is showing some smart design, some good engineering, and most importantly, a lot of good fuel mileage improvements on many of these vehicles, including new engines that are getting 20-30% better mileage.
And speaking of the fuel mileage, one of the cars here is the 2010 Fusion, which is actually right across from us, and the automotive community just loves this car. One of the really cool things about it is the interior. It's actually got what I might call an echo gauge. It's a big LCD screen, and the greener you drive, the more green the leaves are. If you get a little heavy on the foot pedal, well, the leaves are going to fall off. But if you don't want all that gizmo stuff, you can turn it off.
And it's fun. This car premiered as the pace car at the last NASCAR race at Homestead. So we got a good look at it. They even ran one, I believe, on the salt flats for speed. And it's a handsome car. Again, very European in its basics, in its design, and now hybrid. But don't forget, you've got the hybrid Chevys, the hybrid Saturns, the hybrid Saturn View. You've got the Dodge and the Chrysler hybrid SUVs, which are big. And one of them that I tested actually got 20 miles per gallon with a Hemi V8, guys, which means it can tow, go, and go past gas stations. So you got some great stuff that doesn't use as much gas. But then I see there's a nice Corvette or two over there. And we have got the Cadillac XLR. It's the last year of production for that, but that's a Corvette-based luxury sports convertible with a hardtop. You got a lineup of some really good-looking Honda Civics there. I'm sure there's got to be a fuel-efficient version in there. Let's not forget about the new Insight from Honda, which is their Civic size, very inexpensive hybrid four-door.
But, you know, of course, what's interesting, while we have a push for high-mileage cars, here we have the muscle car wars finally really revving up with the production 2010 Camaro across the hall show floor, and the V6 alone getting 300 horsepower. And of course, the last generation Camaro topped out at about 325 for the V8.
And let's not forget that you're probably pushing 500 plus in this GT500 Shelby. You're probably doing 300 plus in the Mustang GT. They've got a brand new design for the interior. The dashboard is one piece, much better built. The outside echoes of the 1969 Mustang with some real aggressive nose. The Camaro is an amazing looking car. It's the first time I've seen a production model in the flesh. You and I did break some stories a year ago on that Mustang with Ed Wilburn. And I'll have to say he did a great job on that car. And then you take a look at that really insidious black Challenger that's over there, and you say, my gosh, that's the 1970s all over, until you get in it, and the car has so much electronics, is fairly fuel efficient, sounds fantastic, and now you can get a 6-speed manual with the SRT8, so you can row your own.
And of course, we had the SRT8 for a week, and you, of course, let me drive that one, and wow, what a ride it was. And the thing that really struck me about it was that wide body, just how big it was. But still, how composed it was.
Yes, very composed, very very nice platform, very nice ride. I dare say that the new Mustang and certainly the new Camaro are going to be comfortable, unlike the 70s and 80s muscle cars, which were a little rough around the edges. nice and comfortable on most roads when you want them to handle. Even the V6 versions, they're probably going to handle pretty well. They've got great rubber and a lot of electronic stability control, etc.
Yeah, and another one that I was looking at just a little bit earlier is the 2010 Buick LaCrosse.
Mm-hmm.
That debuted as a concept last spring in Beijing and just came out last month in production version at Detroit, and it'll be going on sale a little bit later this year. And what's really nice about that one, the interior is gorgeous. I mean, you look at that, it almost reminds you of a Lexus or a Cadillac.
Mm-hmm.
It's really gone up scale.
And they have proven that with J.D. Powers and Associates. They've gotten some very good initial quality on that. You know, one of the great things about the LaCrosse is it brings back some of what Buick was always known for. They were known for a powerful, sleek, aggressive-looking car. That one last step before you got to Cadillac. So now you got a 280 horsepower, direct injection V6 under there. The style is sublime. It really doesn't look much like the Buicks of old. And no surprise they introduced it in China, which is where Buick really wants to expand and explode. Thus, we hope giving Buick a good chance for survival.
And, you know, they're really bringing back the big old Harley Earl era grills, the Buick. I mean, when you look at that thing, a lot of chrome. And, you know, we're going to have a lot more coverage from the Car and Truck Show. Dan and I both will have some other video reports. Amanda Warford's out here, so we hope you're going to keep on streaming. And also, we've got a regular episode of Pod Rods for you as well.
Yeah, we'll have everything from the little smart to the big Dodge Ram here at the Jacksonville International Car and Truck Show.